We had no idea how important it was when we started it. It was just meant to be a lark, creating a comic book contract to make sure that students knew how to behave under certain contractual restraints in relation to IP and non-disclosure agreements for the Makers Club. But what then happened really took us all by surprise. What we'd done was publicized on ABC Radio, on the Law Reports, and the very next day I had about 800 emails in my inbox. And now 4 years down the line, what we've seen is a massive industry response to the idea of making law simple and accessible. Some of them are comic strips with little speech bubbles. Some of them are a bit more wordy, but they will all have in common a series of pictures with some text that really help to drive the behavior that is needed to ensure that there are no disputes in the contract, that everyone is on the same page with expectations for their behavior and the other party's behavior, and it will all sort of end up with a, I hope that we'll have a great relationship and this will be wonderful for everyone, which is what a contract should be. Robert French, the Chief Justice, said that the contracts are of course binding. It's just a question of interpretation. That actually what we just need to make sure of is that these images speak clearly and plainly. In the Oricon contract, they wanted the whole spirit of the employment relationship to be innovative. They're the ones where we've been able to see not just the longest collaboration, but also the biggest impact throughout the entire organization. The whole culture of the institution has changed because of that employment contract that we started out in 2017. It's been remarkable. WACE is WA's individualized services, and their remit is to offer support to people who are disabled but wish to stay in their own home. So we have created an employment contract which will allow disabled people to hire domestic care workers. We've done that with a 7-page comic book, which I'm hoping is approachable and usable for everyone. So we have to be very careful with the interpretation of these images and their meaning and not make assumptions, knowing our industry, knowing our target groups, our demographics and our cultures. We make sure that we run it through at least 2 different focus groups where we compare the text-based version with the image-based version of a given contract. We do this to make sure that we haven't made any mistakes, and we also do this to make sure that there is a marked improvement. We were asked to talk at a Comic-Con in Perth. We had the privilege of talking exclusively to graphic artists and comic book artists about this niche in their profession, and it sparked a lot of interest. And it's true. I mean, we can see it now. We are hiring people, both commercially and on projects. I can't think of more powerful impact than that you've got entire professions springing out of the ground.